Assalamu alaikum and welcome back to Moorish Cuisine. On my day-to-day daily Instagram stories, whenever I share my roti stories, a lot of you asked for roti tutorials. So today I'm sharing how to make dough in a stand mixture with garma garam chapati roti tutorial. So let's go and make it happen. So let's start with bismillah. First, in a stand mixture bowl, I'm adding atta. Today I'm using sujata chakki atta, adding some salt, and I'll add flaxseed meal. So this is grounded flax seeds, and I buy this big bag from Costco. Add that in the dough, and then with the dough hook attached, I'll start on the lowest setting and start adding water little by little. When you make your roti dough with hand, you don't add all the water right away, and that's what we are doing in this stand mixture as well. Keep on adding until you start seeing that there's no dry flour. So just take the dough, take the stand mixture setting to a little higher, on to 4 or 6, and keep on adding water until your dough comes to the desired softness, however soft you can handle your roti dough. And when it comes to that like softness, then keep on mixing on 4 or 6 setting until your dough is completely kneaded. That's what you do with the hand, right? So when dough is come and it's a stick to your dough hook, then take it out. You can check the softener at this time, just press it with your hand, and then just transfer this dough onto the container. My container has to have a lid. Just wet your hand again, and then just put some more water with the wet hand on top of it, cover, and leave it on the counter to rest for at least 20 to 30 minutes so gluten get activated. So whenever you're ready to make your chapatis, just take a little piece from your prepared dough, just add it into your dry flour, and then make a dough ball. This should be a smooth dough ball like so. Just dip it again into the dry flour and put it on the side. Now take one dough ball, press it onto the dry flour, and then start smoothening the edges of the roti. This will make sure that whenever we are rolling it, you will get this very smooth edge. Then start rolling with a very light hand. Just keep on rolling with your fingers from the edges of your rolling pin, and a roti will start rolling by itself. Whenever you think the roti is sticking to your counter or the working surface, just keep on adding the dry flour until you have the desired gold roti. In the end, just keep on rolling from the edges. If you think that some of the edges are thicker, and try to make as gold as you want. The goal should be to get the softer roti rather than a gold roti. So when you think your roti is prepared, just with a very light hand, just transfer it onto your palm and then flip it like this. So all the excess dry flour will fell off. Like you can see, it's falling off on the counter right now. Now your griddle should be heated, and then transfer this prepared roti onto your griddle. Let it cook from one side, then flip, and then I'll cook this roti on to the direct flame, like right onto the stove. Just transfer it onto a stove with the help of tong. Just flip it, let it cook from all the edges. Your heat is the key at this point. When when you were cooking on the griddle should be heated like on the medium to high heat, and same should be with the stove. It should not be very high, otherwise it will burn your roti, but it should be hot, otherwise the roti will turn into like a kadak hard papar kind of roti. In the end, just wrap your roti into a foil and then wrap again into any kind of cloth or dastakhan, and your naram naram and garam garam roti is ready to serve. I think adding flaxseed makes my roti more softer, and of course I'm adding something healthier to my diet. And if you like this tutorial and following it, please let me know how helpful it was. And if you add something else in your roti dough, please let me know in comment as well. And if you want to learn something else, let me know. Leave me a comment down below and I will try my best to make it happen for you guys. Once again, thank you so much for watching. And if you like this recipe, don't forget to click on the links to enjoy a lot more recipes like this.